I hope you guys have a nice breakfast. Okay, ready? I'm the only one between you and your lunch, so you have to be good with me. Okay, so sponsors, we have to show them, of course, they are paying the money. Okay, so my session is real-time collaborative apps with Realm. How many of you guys know about Realm? Okay, only one. Okay, no issues. You will know after this, don't worry. Yeah, so about me, some self-promotion. Okay, so I'm Ravi, and I'm a certified Xamarin developer, a budding astrologer. All my social details are given here, Twitter, Facebook, GitHub, and blog also. So you can catch me anywhere you find comfortable. Okay, so today we'll talk about Realm. What is Realm? How it is different from SQLite, and like how to use Realm with the Xamarin mobile applications, how to create Realm object and manage relations, Realm mobile platform, what is Realm mobile platform, setting up a Realm object server. I'll try to give a couple of small demos if I'm able to, and that's all. Then you'll go for lunch. So what is Realm? Realm is a mobile database. It's a object-based database, which is based on, like, it's a cross-platform database which works on all the platforms, whether it's iOS, Android, and now recently they have given UWP support also. Okay, so it's object-based database. It was launched in 2014. It's very easy to use and very powerful, and it works on all the versions of Xamarin, that is forms also. Like, when we talk about all the versions, we talk about forms specifically because forms are the newest one. So it works on forms also, and it works on Android, iOS, and as I said, it works on UWP also. If you want to go to the component which is used for Realm development in Xamarin, you can go to this URL. This contains the source code of the component which is used as a NuGet package in your Xamarin application. But otherwise, what happens that this is not the Realm database. It's just the component. Actual Realm database is written in C++. Okay, so it's an object-based database which works on in-memory objects. So Realm is not an ORM. Realm, basically, when we talk about mobile databases, we say the only word comes in our mind very first is SQLite, okay? But SQLite is an ORM. Realm is not an ORM. It's not a relationship mapping with the database. Basically, there is no transaction layer. The objects are the database. The actual objects are the database. And there is no joins needed, no design model, okay? Because it is an in-memory database, everything is done inside the memory itself. Reference between the two objects work exactly like the simple objects. Okay, so if you have a C# object, you are connecting with another C# object, it will work just like a normal C# object is working. The Realm database will work just like that. For one-to-many relationship, you will use the ILIST, and for like single relationship, you will just reference the objects, just like you do in your simple object-oriented programming. You reference the object as a property in the other class. So that's how you can do it. It's very fast, and it's good on battery, of mobile, of course. So how to use Realm in code? Realm works on the principle of bait and switch. It's a principle in PCL. So what you have to do is just you have to add the Realm. That's, I have like given the screenshot of NuGet. So you have to just open NuGet, and you can just add Realm to all your projects, whether like Android, iOS, UWP. This is like, this screenshot is from Visual Studio for Windows. So that's why you are able to see this UWP, and you are able to see all the projects in one go. But if you are working on Visual Studio for Mac, you will have to do it individually, by like opening the NuGet packet manager. I'll show you when we are doing the demo. Yes. It's everything is in the memory itself. There is no, yeah, everything is the memory itself. So there are some recommendations which are like after this session I'll give you some like URLs for the Relim documentation and best practices. They have mentioned that how to use Relim in best possible way for better performance. So you can go through that documentation. It will help you out.
Does that mean you need a lot of memory?
It depends. It depends on what kind of application you are developing. It's not necessary that every application will require a lot of memory, but it depends on if you are working on so many objects, you can create small Relim objects. That way it will be lighter on the memory. Okay, so yes, as I was saying that this is for Windows, but for Mac you have to manually add it to all the projects one by one. So example of Relim models. In Relim world, we don't SQLite, we don't have to use the a container or data access method. We just have to create the models inheriting the Relim object class. So when you have to, when you are creating a POCO object, what you have to do is you have to just inherit Relim object class, and everything will be taken care by then Relim framework itself. So if you see there, I have given this department, this thing, ILIST department. So this is one to many relationship, that one, if one employee can go to many departments, so it will be like ILIST. If I want to give just one to one relationship, I'll just remove that ILIST. I'll just give public department is equal to department, just like simple C#. Okay, so it works like that only. You don't have to give this whole, you don't have to create anything else. You just have to do this. So how to use Relim to save the code? So if you want to save the code, what you have to do is you have to just create the object, and you will this code I am adding ID all by myself. The reason behind this is that Relim doesn't support your auto incremental field, just like your SQLite, because it is not a database. Okay, it's just an in collection of in memory objects. So since it is not supporting it doesn't support auto incremental field, there is primary key field, which is basically GUID. So if you want to use GUID, you can set it up as a primary key field, as a string GUID. It will automatically add it up. Otherwise, what I have done here is I have used an integer field, and I'm incrementing it by getting the count of the list. And you can see how easily I can get the Relim database. So if you see the first line, it is saying that get instance. So it's loading the instance, and then it will loading all the values. And then from there, I'm adding it to using that write method. So when we use relimdb.write, and it will automatically add it to the collection, Relim collection. So all the employees will be available in the Relim collection by this. So Relim works on plain queries, simple link queries, just like SQLite. It also works on simple link queries. So you can just if you want to get all the employees, you can just use relimdb.all and pass it as a generic type, data type, and you'll get the employees. If you I'm a veteran, so I have given a veteran method also. If you want to get based on the property years of experience, so if you have more than 10 years of experience, it will give a simple link query will work. Similarly, if you want to and it's always live, your query is always up to date. You don't have to hit refresh or anything like that. It's always up to date. I'll show you in the example. So this is pretty same, I think. Okay, so let me show you a small demo of how we can create a Relim project, and how you can add and update values. This demo I have already blogged about. So if you want, you can get it from my blog also. So this is my application. Is this visible? Let me, sorry. Okay. I think, yeah. Can you guys see it now? Okay. So I have created this application which has like simple pages. So if you see here, to add Relim, what we have to do is we have to go to add packages, and here we'll have to select Relim, and we just have to add this one. So in my case, it's already added. So if you see here, in my case, it's already added. So that's why I'll be just updating the packages, because yesterday my laptop, without asking me, updated the Xcode. So everything has gone haywire since morning. Yep.
This 4D is a dependency on Relim, or it's a separate?
4D is basically Relim's dependency. Basically, as I told you, that Relim's work on the principle of bait and switch. Okay. So Relim uses 4D to get this principle of bait and switch. It internally uses 4D to do implement the I observable collection and all those activities. Everything is taken care by Relim. But yes, 4D is kind of a dependency for Relim. So it's not an independent, this 4D will be automatically added. You don't need to add it. Once you add Relim, 4D will be automatically added to your project. And same goes with iOS also. If you go here, like you have to same go to packages, add packages, and again search for Relim and add it. Since I have already added, so I'll just update this package. Okay, so let's try to execute this one. I'll show you the example and then I'll show you the code, that how does that code works. Okay. Okay, so if you see here, this is a blank list. When I click on add new employee, I can add an employee name. Okay, so yeah, MSC says Mac. Anyways, so it's coming here. So as you can see, it didn't take even a single second to refresh it. When I came into the next page, it just directly showed it. Why? Because we are not like fetching it from anywhere. Relim works on in-memory objects. So the object was there. The moment I saved into the memory, it was there in the other thing. If I object, like if I add in another one, as the moment I hit save, it will go on the next page and it will load it. Okay, so this is how simple Relim works. I'll show you. So what I have done, like in this app.xaml, I'm just opening this main page, And if you see the code of this main page, say here, on appearing, I'm not calling any service or anything. I'm just binding the list, which is, hold for a sec, let me increase the font. Yeah. So on appearing method, I'm just, what I'm doing is I'm just initializing the Relim database and I'm getting all the employees and binding it. So I'm not hitting any service or I'm not doing anything, or like even it's just taking it from the memory. The performance is very fast because it's taking it from the memory. See, when you are using Relim, what do you mean by different way to save it? If you want to save it to the web service, right? That's what you want to say?
Is it persistent or just on memory?
No, it is persistent. It is persistent. That's what I'm saying. It is persistent. So while working, it is taking from the memory, okay? But after all, it is saving from the file. So if I execute this application again, just like any SQLite application, it will load the database. It won't be a blank database now because it has the data. Okay. So that's why it is the best replacement for what I will say that it is the best replacement for SQLite right now available. The reason being, number one, it is in-memory database. The performance is fast. Number two, it's easy to implement. As I showed you, it's pretty easy to implement. You can just add, delete. There are methods available. You can add, delete, and whatever you want to do, you can do. You can query using link. So all these things can be done pretty easily. So it is in memory, it is fast. And another best feature of Relim above SQLite is like you can encrypt Relim also. So there is a method to encrypt also. I haven't implemented this in this demo, but yes, you can encrypt your local Relim database. So data encryption is available, which is not there in SQLite. If you want to use if you planning to use SQLite in your application, Xamarin application, and if you want to encrypt the data, you will have to go for some component. You have to buy some component. But this one, the RelimDB, it's free, and you can utilize it as an encrypted database also. So that is another benefit of using RelimDB. So this was a simple sample where I have shown how to add. So if you see, this is the list where I'm this loading it. And if you see this adding component, here also what I'm doing, right now it's just a simple application. So that's why I'm pulling the data directly from the fields. So that's why it's like text and all those things. But if you are using MVVM model, you can bind it with MVVM properties also. And you can do just like that only here also. Like you have just created the object, you have binded the properties, and then when you do relim.add, it will add that object to the database. Simply, even for edit also, if you see, it's sending the employees, and on saving, we are changing the updates and it's everything is done in form of transactions, okay? So if you are doing batch transaction, if you're adding batch objects, what you can do is like you don't need to, you can just use the Relim transaction object and the transaction will be maintained, okay? So it will be like if anything goes wrong, it will automatically roll back the whole code. Otherwise, if it works fine, everything will be like put into the database. So this was a simple demo. So this was for like offline development. Like if you are developing a mobile app, you can develop it using RelimDB. And RelimDB is like independent mobile database, a small independent mobile database, which you can use to develop mobile applications. Okay. So apart from RelimDB, Relim also provide a framework called Relim Object Server. Okay. So what happens here is Relim Object Server is basically a mapping with it's kind of a backend for your mobile Relim database. So if you are working on if you use this Relim object server, it has all the features. Like it has a sync engine, it has a dashboard, it has authentication system, it has action control, object store, and it has its own event framework. So you can all use all these features of Realm Object Server, and it has like some encryption layer also, but encryption here is paid. You have to buy either professional or enterprise version. But for development version, the developer version is free. And if you are using Mac, so there is a Mac instance of Realm Object Server also. So you can download the Mac instance of Realm Object Server. You can execute locally, and then you can run your application on that. So that's how you can use the Realm Object Server. And Realm Object Server has direct mapping with your Realm mobile database. You just need to provide the connection string, and it will automatically hook up and do the sync and everything. Okay. Yes. What?
Only the enterprise part is paid.
Because see, in enterprise, they give you the facilities like full database, data connectors. So if you want to use Realm Object Server as a sync server between your actual database and your Realm mobile database, you can do that also. Okay. So for it's best suited like for the applications where you are doing this kind of applications where real-time collaboration is needed. Okay, so this RealmDB gives you real-time sync with your mobile apps using a simple like single line connection string. Okay, yes?
So if I'm using encryption on the mobile, mm-hmm. should I be using encryption on the server as well, or it's not needed?
It's not needed. It's not necessary. For like if you are planning to use encryption on the server, then of course you have to go for enterprise version. Yeah. But yeah, if you are using encryption on mobile, you don't need to, it's not necessary.
With that, we can build some applications and
yes.
Things encrypted on the phone.
Yes. I'm using RealmDB on like in most of my application only on phone. I'm not using Realm Object Server. So Realm Object Server is best suited for the application. For example, you are creating a chat application. Okay, if you are planning to create a WhatsApp-like chat or Messenger application, Realm is best suited for that kind of scenario. Like Realm Object Server, I'm talking about. Realm Object Server is best suited for that kind of scenario. Even they have example, pre-written example. I was trying to execute that, but as I said, that my OS got in some issues. So. But yes, it has like they have many examples of real-time collaboration apps which you can do using Realm Object Server. But if you don't want to use Realm Object Server, you can just use Realm Mobile in your regular mobile application. That's what I'm doing. I'm not using Realm Object Server in any of my commercial applications. For most of my clients, I'm using Realm Mobile as a local database only. I'm just calling their web services. I'm fetching the data, keeping like storing all the offline database on the Realm Object Server because it's easier to use. And hey, I'm not Realm employee, so I'm not selling Realm here. I'm just sharing my experience, like what's good for a developer. Okay.
In fact, we can come up with our own server to synchronize this as well because it fires all the events that are needed whenever some change happens. Mm-hmm. It does fire the event. That's how. With the Xamarin forms binding, it automatically updates the UI and all, right?
Are you talking about Realm Object Server?
No, I'm talking about Realm on the phone.
Yes.
It does fire the events whenever some change happens.
Yes.
If a new item is added.
Yes.
If an item is edited.
Yes.
It fires an event. That's how the UI is automatically updated.
Agreed.
We can subscribe to the same events.
Yeah.
And then automatically send that change to the server.
Yes.
We can come up with our own server to synchronize.
Of course. People have done that. People have used Realm with Azure. People has used Realm with AWS. So I'm like, they have done that. So you can, of course, synchronize with your own servers and utilize it. But as I said, that Realm is a mobile database is separate. And this one is like Realm Object Server is a separate for separate requirements. So the Realm Object Server is primarily developed on the basis of prime concepts of RealmDB, that it is like based on object offline first. The queries run locally. The write of the queries applies immediately, and the reactive architecture. Yes, Realm is also best suited for reactive development. If you are following like using reactive extension of Xamarin, then you can use RealmDB for development. It's like best suited for that also. And it automatically sync happens in the background. Like the sync automatically happens if you are using RealmDB, Realm Mobile, and Realm Object Server. It automatically syncs in the background. You don't need to like do the syncing or anything. You just have to give the connection string, and it automatically syncs in the background. Realm right now is available on, So Realm Object Server is right now available as like developer installation as for Mac OS. So you can get it, like you can download it from Realm. I'll share the link from where you can get it. So it's available as a Mac OS bundle. There is really like Linux online installer available. So once you have Linux setup, it supports like CentOS and Ubuntu. And it also has support on Amazon EC2. And if you want to buy, like if you don't want to go into the hassle of like installing or setting up Realm, you can buy like Realm object server instances from DigitalOcean. So DigitalOcean has kind of partnered up with Realm, and they are like selling it as a Realm object server instances on the cloud. So you can purchase it from there. And you can use it. And even because on Azure, you have to basically set up the Ubuntu server, and on the Ubuntu server you have to install Realm, and you have to do the setup and installation all by yourself. But in case of like DigitalOcean, they have like they have done all the setups. You just you can just buy the Realm instance and you can utilize it. Okay, so let me show you. So this is Realm Object Server working like running locally on my Mac. If you see here, it has like Realms, it has users. Right now I have only one user assigned to it. So it has only one user here, and Realms there, then functions, log. So this is the local server which is running on my Mac. Similarly, and it is very easy to install. You have to just download it from the link. I'll share the link. So you can just download it from where they have the setup. You can just download the zip file, unzip it, and execute the, there is one command file. If you just execute that command file, it will automatically open the terminal, and it will open this instance. And that instance will be running till you have kept that terminal window and command file running, like this one, see this one. This is my server running. So it's a local server. You can move it anywhere. Like initially, I downloaded it, it was in my downloads folder. Then I moved it to C drive. So you can move it anywhere, and you can just run it from there itself. So that instance will run on your machine itself. Okay. And I don't have installed that, but there is one. So yeah, here is the link. So you can just download the Mac OS bundle. You can just unzip it. And then once you unzip it, yeah, you have to just run this start object server.dot command. So you just double click on this, and it will automatically run this it will automatically run this script as like this in the terminal window. And then it will show you the object server in the browser of your choice, whatever default browser you have set. Okay. So let me try to execute the applications once again if I have that. So this is another application. This is the sample given by Realm. And if you see here, this is how we are connecting to the Realm database. You have to just give URL, Realm get messages, Realm, and then this URL. And if you see here, it is just creating the installation from here. So from synchronization, it's just getting the users and showing it. Let me try to execute it. If it works, fine. If it doesn't work, then probably we'll move ahead. Okay, so I think it's giving some issues. So where to go next from here? I would suggest you guys to go through Relim Docs. So Relim Docs is the official documentation of Relim. You can get the like Relim from there. Then you have like a mobile platform installation guide. You can get it from there. The link is all there. The simplest example of Relim, which I showed just now, I have blogged it also, a step-by-step guide. It's there on my blog. You can download from my blog. And then you can go to the Relim Xamarin guide. You can get it from there. And the component code is, as I mentioned earlier also, the component code is available on this. Okay. So since seeing your hungry faces, I tried to finish it up earlier. Now, thank you very much. Just questions, if anyone has any. Yes.
I saw the example you use right. What's the difference and when to use one or
all? See, when you are doing in case of transaction, in the sample, second one, what I was doing was I was editing a record. Okay. So when you are editing a record, you are using transaction, then you will do begin write. Or if you are entering, if you are doing an insert, or if you are directly entering that record, you can just use write. Yeah, both are same, just like it's when you are doing a batch processing also, you can use begin write and end write. So you can do that. Otherwise, like you can, if you have one single object, you can just use write to enter the object. Yes.
I want to include data, so how do we manage the keys, integration key?
Okay.
The key is hardcoded in the software, some other ways to manage
this? So yes, you have to give, they have encryption mechanism and they have like key, actually I haven't used the encryption much. So, but yes, you have like, they have SHA encryption something, and if you go through the guides, they will tell you how you can, where you can store the key and how to utilize in your application.
So this is a configuration?
Yeah, it is kind of a configuration change. But not much. While doing the coding itself, while creating the instance for the first time, you will give the encryption key, whatever you want to do, and then you can do that. I didn't get you. I'm sorry.
Okay. So the configuration is a real configuration. It's not application configuration.
No. It's an application configuration. While creating the Relim object, like get instance, if you see the code here, like this one. So here, this get instance.
Okay.
So see this here. It has Relim configuration base. So this, you have to create a configuration file like this, in which you will pass the encryption and everything, all the details, and then when you use this to create a Relim object, that will be an encrypted, it will be stored in an encrypted database. Okay. Yes.
So is there any limitations to the Realm mobile, the freebase plan? Is there any limitations to that, like number of requests per second or
Are you talking about Relim mobile on the mobile?
Yeah, on the Relim mobile, yeah.
No, there is no limitation. You can use it.
Store as much as you want.
Yeah, it's totally depend on the memory of your phone. So as much memory as your phone supports, as much RAM as your phone support, you can do it.
But
because
it does sync to the online Relim backend, right?
It syncs if you are using Relim Object Server. If you are not using Relim Object Server, then it's only locally. Like the way I use it is like I don't use Relim Object Server. I use my own clients, like they have web services and all. So I fetch data from their web services. I store it locally on like in the Relim database. Instead of SQLite, I'm using Relim database. So I'm like, yes, it is a best SQLite replacement, I would say.
Okay, so when you want to sync, you manually sync your local stuff to your clients' database online.
Yes, yes. Yeah, that also you can do. That also you can do. And as he has said, you can also use the Relim has data binding capabilities also, and you can capture that sync methods of that Relim component to, instead of syncing to the Relim object server, you can like match it with syncing with another server if you want to.
Okay.
Right. Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Yes, Gary.
Does it do some kind of property level tracking of changes? Because, I mean, so is there some magic, for example, in this transaction log, what happens if the qualification setting fails?
Mm-hmm.
So then the empty name property is restored back to the previous state, or?
Yeah, it does. Basically, it is, as I said, it has all the implementation. By default, it implements that iReflection interface, iObservable interface, and it implements all the interfaces required. So it has, you don't even need to, it has the binding also. So you don't need to do any kind of like mapping in that scenario. So it is done all, it follows all the ACID principle of the database. The only thing is that it doesn't store the data relationally like a regular relational database. It stores it in the in the form of a file.
But these were just normal properties?
Yeah, these are the just the normal properties which you can, in the form of like configuration,
what
you can set.
In the
which one?
For example, the
model.
Yeah, this one. Yeah, these are just the property. But what happens? See, when you are going here. Wait for a sec. Yeah, employees. So see, when you inherit from this realm object, remember when you are using any MVVM or any framework, you are just inheriting from the base class, and base class has all the implementation. Similarly, realm object has all these implementation. Which does all the binding and everything is taken care by this. So if you go to,
I think he's asking about some validation fails. What happens?
Not only by just you don't have to trigger the on property change.
No. You don't have to trigger the on property change. You don't have to trigger.
How does it do that?
It take case. If you see here, it already has I notify property change and I schema change implementation. This is your realm object. It is already implementing your iNotify property change and iSchema source. So when you are binding, like when you are inheriting it, it has already done this implementation in the realm framework.
Yeah, but normally whenever you are actually changing your property, you call the notify property.
Yes, I know. You have to do that, but here they have done it.
Something like commit, is it? If it is a transaction, when you commit, it happens.
Yeah. They have like, they have transactional implementation also. So when you are writing, when you are using the write method. So when you are adding write method to it, it automatically does all the commit and property change implementation and everything. Yeah.
Actually, it will trigger the auto notify property change at the time when you say commit and
notify. Yes. Yes.
Makes sense.
Yes.
Okay.
Anyone else? Okay, thank you for your time. Thanks a lot.